The Go Green at Your Library series continues this month at the Thomas Crane Public Library with the showing of the documentary film Unfractured. Two separate showings, actually, Monday, January 7th from 7 to 8:30 at the Adams Shore Branch on C Street, and then again on Wednesday, January 16th from 7 to 8:30 p.m. at the main branch in Quincy Center. Quincy Climate Action Network has teamed up with the library to present this film, and Alice Arena and Faye Strigler are here to tell us a little bit about how they got involved and how you might benefit from it as well. So ladies, welcome, welcome. Thanks for coming over.
Thank you for having us.
Great to see you both. And Alice, you're also with the group FRACS, right? Four River Residents Against the Compressor Station as
yes.
well.
Yep.
And also QCAN?
Well, we have worked with QCAN collectively, for the past 3 years
least,
where we have used our networks for their presentations. And so this is just another collaboration with QCAN.
Okay. So tell me a little bit about Unfractured. This is a documentary film. And does that mean that it's a true story?
Yes, okay. It's definitely a true story, sort of one woman's journey into activism and what that activism ended up meting out for not just her, but for the situations that she found herself in.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Does that sound?
Yes. I had read a book of hers, Raising Elijah, several years ago. I can't even remember why, but I couldn't put the book down. It was very engaging. It was about raising children in a time of environmental crisis.
Okay.
And she talked a lot about different situations of people banding together and taking care of their children, basically. And when I heard that she was going to be speaking in Jamaica Plain and that there was a movie about her life, I told people about it and we all went. And when we got there, we found out that the filmmaker was giving 50 communities a chance to apply to show a free screening of the film, and
okay.
that's how this all happened.
Okay, so you applied for that and
we won.
And you won.
Yep.
Very good. Now, the she that you're referring to is Sandra Steingraber, is that right?
Yes.
Okay. And do you know anything about her life or where she's from? Or?
Yes.
Okay.
She wears many hats. She's a scientist. She's an author and poet.
Mm.
She's a parent. She is the champion of the fight to ban fracking in New York State.
I see.
She's quite an amazing person. She started out wanting to be a writer and a poet. She got bladder cancer when she was in her early 20s, and that changed the direction of her life. She went back to school. She got a PhD in biology, and she has written extensively about cancer and environmental factors in cancer. I remember a time when you didn't mention cancer
mm-hmm.
and environmental
the
factors
C word, right?
in the same sentence,
yeah.
you know, and that has changed
yeah.
because of people like Sandra Steingraber.
Okay.
And she's a wonderful activist, and she does it, and she's very passionate about what she does.
Okay, and this film, Unfractured, is kind of documenting that story, right? That story of hers. And it's relatively new, is that right, Faye? It was out just about a year ago?
Yes.
Okay,
yeah.
okay. And have you heard any reaction from it or response from it or any, you know, motivation from it at all?
What do you mean?
Has any action happened because of it, you know, when it comes to the fracking cause?
Oh, I think it's... there have been many other cities and countries that have banned fracking
mm-hmm.
because of it. New Brunswick has banned it. I have a list.
Mm-hmm.
Let me see.
Mm-hmm.
Maryland,
yep.
New Brunswick, Scotland, Ireland, Northern Ireland, Wales, the Netherlands, parts of Florida, California, and Argentina.
Oh, okay, okay. Yes. And her goal is to have it in New York State. Banned as well, right?
It's already been banned.
Oh, it has.
And she started, and people started fighting this when there was already a temporary moratorium. So that's when they started to make the moratorium permanent.
I see. Okay.
Yes.
All right. Now, let's talk a little bit about the showings of the film here in Quincy. Again, two separate showings, Monday, January 7th, the Adam Shore branch from 7 to 8:30, and then on the 14th, the 16th, Wednesday the 16th, also 7 to 8:30 at the main branch. So what's happening those evenings?
So on those evenings, and this again is QCAN really is doing the legwork as Faye did to get the film itself. We will have the film, and I'm sure usually what happens is there's usually a small talk before the film to talk about how, not just about the film, but what does it mean for us here in the Four River Basin?
Right.
How does it translate into something that is effective and for people to listen to? And I think that it's really great that it is at the Adam Shore Branch because the Germantown area and Quincy Point areas of Quincy are environmental justice areas. And one of the things about environmental justice is they look at the health of the populations.
Mm-hmm.
And that's something that FRAX has been doing and we're going to continue to do. And fracking and the whole infrastructure from fracking that's coming all the way up here and they're trying to put the compressor mm-hmm. in Weymouth is going to affect people's health.
Okay.
You know, there's been a lot of studies on the fact that the off-gassing from these facilities, the toxins that are sort of right there at the wells, mostly in Pennsylvania, travel the pipelines and come into your stove, for instance.
Okay.
So we're looking at, you know, that kind of thing. Sandra also, because she had cancer and because she started looking at this is what her life work has been, is to say, what we throw into the environment, we take into our bodies, mm-hmm. and this is what is causing, you know, these kind of things.
So, Faye, what is kind of the ultimate goal of bringing this film to Quincy? You know, what do you hope to come out of it?
Well, I think climate change, the source of these chemicals and the source of climate change is the same. It's fossil fuels, we've just heard about the Intergovernmental Panel of Climate Change report and also the National Climate Assessment that was worked on by hundreds of scientists and came out of the White House.
Mm.
And we have to cut fossil fuel emissions by 45% to 50% by 2030.
Mm-hmm.
We don't, or we're going to have runaway climate change. So we really have to do a lot of work. The good thing is that we already have the technology to fix a lot of these things. We offshore wind turbines in Massachusetts are gangbusters,
mm-hmm.
and we have there's a lot of work been done on wind turbines and solar
mm-hmm.
In Quincy too. We had solarized Quincy
right.
here, so we have the technology. But we all need to be involved. And Steingraber was very adamant about that. She said, everyone should be writing. I'm writing, you know.
Okay.
But everyone should be writing their stories.
Okay, so the goal is motivate people, at least to talk about the issue, right? And maybe take action if possible.
Yes. Yeah. We really need to do that.
Okay. We actually have a little preview of the film that we're going to show our viewers right now to give them a little taste. But again, the presentation, these are free, right? Free showings?
Yes.
Okay. Again, Monday, January 7th, 7 to 8:30 at the Adam Shore Branch. And then on the 16th, which is a Wednesday evening, from 7 to 8:30 at the main branch. It's Unfractured, a documentary film. And here's a little preview. Ladies, thank you so much for joining us. And
thank
good luck
you,
with
Joe.
Your presentation.
Thank you, Joe.
You're very welcome.
My name is Sandra Steingraber, and I am Unfractured. Yes, we are back, and we will keep coming back until fracking is stopped in New York.
We won't stop until Governor Cuomo protects our health and our environment.
This morning, I said goodbye to my sweetheart in room 438 of the Medical Center. I'm here today speaking for both of us.
Fracking brings temporary profits to a few and permanent ruin for many.
There is not a single case in this country where the hydraulic fracturing process has polluted a groundwater supply. Not a single one.
I was sitting there with 2 pages worth of studies showing thousands of cases of water contamination. I'd like to say I never disappoint my kids. I disappoint my kids. I almost feel like I'm dealing with an 85-year-old instead of somebody who's in his 50s, you know? My heart's broken in 1,000 pieces right now. This is what my country has brought.
You know, the antidote to despair and cynicism is to fight with your whole heart.
So people risking arrest, red armbands.
Because we have tried our voices, today our bodies are delivering the message.
If we need to fill these jails with our bodies to stop this plant, we are ready to take that tactic.